Hi guys and welcome. So today I'm going to be doing a CPU performance comparison between AMD Ryzen 5600X and the Apple M1 found in this MacBook Air. So this is not a very fair comparison in a way because I'm comparing a fully fledged desktop CPU with a proper cooler to a passively cooled chip in an ultra thin and ultra light laptop. But still, I think it's a really interesting comparison to make to see if the Apple M1 can compete with the latest and greatest desktop CPUs, even in a very thermally constrained environment like a MacBook Air. Now, just to give you a little lowdown on the chips, the Ryzen CPU has 6 cores and 12 threads. The M1 has 8 cores in total, with 4 cores being high performance and 4 cores being high efficiency. So we're gonna start off with Geekbench 5. So yeah, let's get started. So amazingly, the Apple M1 has a slight advantage over the Ryzen in single core performance in Geekbench with a score of 1743 versus 1602. The Ryzen takes the lead in multicore though, where it gets a score of 7,857 versus 7,647 for the M1. Now, the fact that the M1 competes here is impressive when you consider that it has a significant clock speed deficit, running at about 3.2 GHz maximum compared to up to 4.6 GHz on the Ryzen. So now we're going to take a quick look at Cinebench R23, starting off with a single core performance test. So here, the chips are almost neck and neck with only a 2% difference in score. The Ryzen takes a slight lead with a score of 1521 versus 1491, the M1. Again, it's quite impressive the M1 is keeping up here, considering it has a clock speed deficit of over 1 GHz compared to the Ryzen. The M1 is really flexing its higher IPC here. So now we'll take a look at Cinebench again, this time though, the multicore benchmark. So here the Ryzen takes a commanding lead with a score of 10,538 versus 6,392 on the M1. Here the Ryzen really gets to flex its muscles with those 6 big cores, desktop TDP and beefy cooling. We can see in this benchmark though the impact that the lack of a fan on the M1 has on sustained performance under full load. AnandTech did the same test but instead on an M1 powered Mac Mini, where they got a score of 7,833. Now that score is around 23% higher than the score I got on my MacBook Air, because the Mac Mini of course has a fan that allows it to perform better under sustained load because it can dissipate the heat better, whereas on the passively cooled MacBook Air, the chip likely has to throttle to control temperatures. Now I thought it'd be interesting to do a quick analysis on the efficiency of these chips. In terms of power consumption, at full load across all 6 cores, the Ryzen CPU uses around 55 watts, according to the Ryzen Master software. In their M1 Mac Mini review, AnandTech found that their system used about 22 watts at the wall under sustained CPU load across all cores. Now, it's not entirely fair to compare these two figures, as the Mac Mini at the wall figure includes everything in the system, you know, RAM, GPU, it also includes any inefficiencies of the power supply, whereas the Ryzen figure is for the CPU cores only. That being said, you tend to find desktop CPUs are tuned for absolute performance and efficiency is not as high of a concern as compared with mobile. This can lead to better performance but lower efficiency overall. So if we do take the Cinebench multi-core scores and divide them by the power consumption in watts, we found the M1 Mac Mini gets around 349 points per watt compared to 191 points per watt for the Ryzen. So the M1 is a lot more energy efficient. Now the M1 is manufactured on the newer 5nm TSMC process compared to TSMC's 7nm process for the Ryzen, which I suspect is a significant part of the difference here. But also a large part of it is that the Ryzen is running at significantly higher clock speeds. Higher clock speeds need a higher voltage, and power consumption goes up exponentially with voltage. So yeah, the scary thing about this, if you're Intel anyway, is that AMD CPUs are generally a lot more energy efficient than their Intel counterparts these days. So you can only imagine what a bloodbath it would be in terms of efficiency when comparing Intel chips versus Apple's M1. That might be a future video, maybe. My work laptop does have an Intel chip in it, so that could be a very interesting thing to see. On the whole, both of these chips are pretty awesome, and in fact, I'd argue that 2020, with the release of both the Ryzen 5000 series and the Apple M1, was the most exciting year for desktop CPUs in a decade. It finally feels like there's competition and innovation in this space again, after getting the same reheated 40nm Intel chips year after year after year. I'm particularly looking forward to seeing how Apple's higher-end chips perform. Maybe we'll see an M1X in new high-end MacBook Pros later this year. So anyway, thank you very much for watching. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please consider subscribing if you loved it. And yeah, let me know what you thought in the comments as well. Yeah, thank you very much. Cheers. Bye.